Hello everyone, this is Pankaj Chauhan. I welcome you all again in this platform. Today our guest is Mr. Srinu. First I welcome him. Hello Srinu, how are you?
Hi Pankaj, how are you?
I'm also good. So first I want to tell about you to our viewers. Actually he's a Srinu, he's from electronics background and he got All India rank 146 in his GATE exam, and now he's posted as a executive engineering trainee in NTPC Solarpur. Okay, so Srinu, this is the video series in which we are discussing about your interview experience and exam preparation, everything, so that our juniors get some benefit, right, from this video, right?
Yes.
Okay. So this is the main motto basically, and in this video meeting, we will do is that we will start from your journey, like how you start a study and then how you got that much good rank and then how you crack the interview of NTPC, and everything we'll discuss, and anything you want to share with our viewers, it will be very good for us and our viewers. Okay.
Oh yes.
Okay, so Srinu, what we do first, we will start with introduction. So please tell about your introduction.
Yeah, as Pankaj told, my name is Mamidi Srinu Babu and I'm from electronics and communication engineering background, and I have secured All India rank 146 in the GATE exam.
Okay.
So coming to my background, I came from a very rural background, and till now there is no internet connectivity or phone signal in that village.
So
I came from that kind of background, and I have struggled a lot to write the online exams, or that I have to travel some other villages or to my relatives' rooms to write the exams.
Okay. So I just repeat once again that he is from electronics background, and one thing I want to tell to our viewers that he is like belong to such area there is no network. Okay, so he will find very difficult. His struggling time is struggling period is very difficult. Like he have no any internet connection, so how he preparing the for exam and everything is so like so inspirational. Okay, so we'll discuss everything from start to end. So first time I will ask about your background, like you are telling that you have no network connections, and so the people there is how much educated they are?
No, there if you see the average education is not below the 10th class is also not, we cannot say that it's like they were dropping in between. If you consider it, average is like a 10th standard.
Okay, so from that background means how you thought that you have to do that much big thing, how you thought?
No, my father initially motivated me to study the things, and we used to get a newspaper. At that time no one was getting newspaper, only my only our family, or we used to get the newspaper that is in Telugu. So I used to read it, and I used to have some awareness about the society, what is going on.
So
at that time also my father joined me in an English medium school. It is first of its kind, and it was only one school in that area, and I was the first student at the time to join in that school. So I think it has.
So that school is in your area, means your local area, or you have to travel somewhere?
No, it is like 20 kilometers from my village, and without earlier we used to travel with the RTC buses, that means state government buses. It is at 7 o'clock in the morning, so we have to wake up at 5 and we have to get ready, and 7 o'clock you have to fetch the bus. If the bus is not there, again you have a bus at 10 o'clock, which was I was late to the school. Like that in the evening also it's very difficult to reach home.
So you are the first, as you told that you are the first one from who study English medium, right?
No, from my village, not nearby.
From your village, that's a big thing also. That's also a big thing. So first of thing, I want to congratulate you and I want to salute you that from that background you got that much higher position in this like in this tough time. So first of thing, I want to congratulate you on your achievement.
Thank you so much.
Okay,
means so for me.
okay so for the viewers, I want to say that it's a very like a motivated story, like it is motivational story that for those who are watching this video, because he's from such a background that he was the first one who studied English medium, right? So please watch this video till the end. You will definitely get some good points from this video. Okay, so Srinu, we will start from your synchronize journey. Okay, ki from where, which, at what point of time you came across which difficulty, and at what point of time you decide to do something. Okay, before that, I want to ask one more thing, that why you choose engineering as a career, and why especially electronics?
Before that, I want to tell, I was interested in mathematics, and I used to understand well mathematics in my 10th standard. So I have joined in the MPC in intermediate.
Okay.
After that, I heard, I don't know about engineering or what are the branches, what actually does, like, but someone told me that ECE is good, and at the time it has some craze. So I have joined in ECE.
No, no. So you were in, you must be in contact of some like person who were doing like engineering. Yeah, you only aware of
that. One guy, yes, one guy is there in my family who was at the time studying in IIIT.
Okay,
so yeah, he also suggested me to join something like EC. Like,
okay, so you didn't know about IITs, NITs at that time of when you were passing plus two exam?
No. I know. I have qualified, I think, JEE mains, I have qualified, but at the time we don't have that much awareness that NITs are bigger than the local colleges. And my family was also not willing to send me out, so I joined somewhere in Andhra Pradesh only, JNTU.
Okay,
after MCET rank.
Okay, so you joined that the college, that college is private college?
No, it's a government college, JNTU Vijayanagaram, first name.
Okay, so you joined that college and you did your BTech there, EC. So yes. At what point of time in your undergraduation that you think of GATE, you thought of GATE, you get like you have to do that exam?
Third year I thought of it, giving a GATE exam.
Okay.
And I started preparation from, I think, almost at the end of the third year.
So you start doing preparation for you have enough knowledge of GATE exam that PSUs are there, IITs are there, everything is, you know.
At the BTech level I was okay, I was like not other people. Okay. Good background.
Okay. That's a nice, so nice. Okay. So we'll start now about your GATE preparation. Okay. So in your first attempt, as you know, as you tell told me before, that you didn't qualify, right?
Yes.
So what was the reason you didn't able to even qualify that exam, and now you are All India rank 146?
Yes, initially in 2017 I have gone for coaching also, but it has not gone well, and I almost not completed the coaching. I left in between.
Okay, so at the time mostly, I'm saying that at the time of your BTech, you once gave one attempt, na GATE attempt.
Yes, in 2017 only, this after.
Okay, so you didn't qualify in that GATE exam.
Yeah. Okay. That's what I'm telling, the reason why I have.
Okay. No, please.
I was more focused on the theory, and I want to learn like everything, not leaving anything, and not the exam point of view, but I'm thinking in my own style.
Okay.
But it didn't go well in the exam, so I have not qualified. I think 22.5 is something the mark, but I have not even didn't reach that also.
Okay. So first time you didn't able to qualify even. Okay. So yes, after that was failure. What thought came in your mind? What I have to do next? Why didn't you join any company, any job?
No, there was some software placements were going in our college, but I have never attended any interview also, because my mind is fixed to the core jobs only.
Okay, so you want to
or a PSU? One thing is fixed, that I want to work in a PSU, that is fixed.
Okay,
so I want to give one more attempt in the next year, coming year.
Okay. So you didn't have a fear of like failure at that time, when you got that much less marks, and what you were thinking of that, how you will get that much good marks?
But I know that where I have done the mistake, no, how was my preparation, and I thought that this is not the way to do it. I was confident about myself that I can do the things, but at the time it didn't work well. That's the point.
So that's a very positive point. He said, any mark, any failure you have, like you face, but if you have a good confidence and you have your self belief is very good, then you can do anything. Like he's a live example here that he didn't qualify in the first attempt, and now he's a All India rank 146. So it's a very great example. Okay, so now when you started coaching. So what difference you feel from self-preparation to coaching? What difference you feel?
Initially, when I joined coaching in the final year,
yeah,
I felt it is good. Initially, I have not studied that much in the college, and it's like I am understanding something. If I want to tell frankly, means I started learning something.
Mm-hmm.
Is from when I went for the coaching. After that, I know how to deal the things or how to handle the things. That means they have guided me. I can say that.
Okay, sir. Okay, means you covered all the syllabus, I think. At that time, you covered all the syllabus and concepts are now good. So, I think you will, you got a good rank in second attempt, I think. Right?
No, initially I went for the coaching for the first attempt, but I didn't qualify. After that, I have
not. Okay. Yeah.
Coach.
Okay. Then?
After that, I never went for the coaching, but I have started looking at these NPTEL sources.
Okay.
And I'm trying to do on my own the problems, and I have more focused on the practice and the previous year questions. So I somehow come to such a level that I can clear the exam.
Okay. So your focus was to clear the exam or to get good rank?
Yeah, clearing and qualifying is not a matter for me, but getting a good rank, like I thought it is better to get below 200 rank, something like that.
Okay.
The time of 2018, I think.
Okay, so at the time of preparation, like you were saying that you are preparing by own. So how you are preparing? What was the main point? Like you are doing some test series. How you are practicing that time? The questions.
Yeah, initially I used to prepare one topic from a particular subject, and I used to do some objective questions on that until I was okay with the theory.
Okay.
Then I used to attempt some topic-wise tests in the test series.
Okay.
So slowly building the confidence, and I am doing in such a regular intervals of revision also I used to do.
Okay. So what if your rank in test series is not up to the mark? Whatever you thinking, if the rank is not up to the mark, so what was your next plan?
No, I don't have any plan. At the time, I was only finding only one choice, that is GATE. Whenever it will finish, it will finish. I don't have
No. Now, I'm asking one thing. When you are giving GATE like a test series, right?
Mm-hmm.
So at some point you might be get less mark in test series. So this thing didn't make you frustrate?
No, frustration never came to me, because we have to study something. No, everything we cannot be known, so we have to update for the next test, and we have to study something more, and we have to write the test again.
So you are so positive at that time that you have to do something, huh? So where did you do coaching? Like you are saying that your area, there's a network problem and everything, so you I think from home somewhere.
No, when I was doing BTech, at the weekend, Saturday and Sunday were holiday. No? At the time, I used to went for a coaching center in Visakhapatnam.
Okay.
In the weekend batches, I used to go.
Okay. So, what was the result when your second attempt you gave? What was the rank?
I got around 3,300, something like that.
Okay, so you were satisfied. So you were satisfied.
I don't know I'm satisfied or not, because after coming to the exam, I was not actually serious, and it's just like that I have wrote, because I have left somewhere the seriousness.
Why?
That means maybe I am preparing on my own, and things were not going in my way. So I thought it at that time, what after getting the GATE result, I thought it is okay.
Means you already knew that key somewhere you left the preparation, and somewhere you find
initially after disqualifying the GATE, I have started from the scratch again, and I was going, and the syllabus was not completed up to 2018.
Okay.
So I have left some subjects, so it was ended at the time.
So Madhulay, there's a lot of ups and down in your preparation time, right?
Yes. Everything in my preparation, each and everything I have learned from experience. That's why I have taken more time.
Okay. So if time is more, some people do in very less time, but if time is taking time is more, so if you are doing hard work continuously, then thing will be in your side at the end. So this thing is surely did by Srinu. Okay, so after 3,000 rank, what is the next thought came in your mind?
Next door means I have to prepare again for GATE or I have to join MTech.
Okay. Not of job. Still not of job. Didn't want to.
No, I was never thinking of going to the software side and no job. Okay, I think let me give one more try. Like that, I thought.
Okay. So it's your third attempt. Now you're preparing for third attempt. Now you have to decide one thing from MTech, either MTech, either job, either preparing. So you
decide.
Tell me.
Yes. Sorry to interrupt. Yeah. Definitely, I need to join for MTech because I cannot stay at home after 2 years break at home. I want to join MTech and I want to prepare there if time permits.
So you'll join MTech just for the preparation, just for the sake of preparation, right? Okay. So
something like that. Not only just for preparation, but there are two things that if MTech was interesting for me, then I will do MTech seriously. Otherwise, I'll prepare for GATE again. I thought that's my initial impression about that.
Okay, so I just want to add one point here that I met Srinu at my MTech because he did all MTech there in ISC Cebu. So I met there. We were a roommate. So we already say a lot of things. And actually, one more thing I want to add. He's a good player of badminton. So we used to play badminton there. So there we met, and there I saw that he's preparing for GATE exam also with MTech. So. Now you are in MTech, right? In that phase, in this phase, now you are in MTech and you are preparing also. So now, what are the changes you made in yourself that you have to prepare this time in this way so that you will get good rank?
Yes. So I have studied for 2 years now, no? So theory. So I focused more on the practice of the questions.
Okay.
And in an ordered way, like doing test series in regular intervals. So I used to prepare in that way.
Mm-hmm.
And almost I have dedicated my total time to GATE only. MTech was not interesting me at that time, so I left MTech like that.
He dropped MTech in between because he was very focused about his dream, that he had to do a GATE exam and a very good rank, and he wanted to go in PSUs and something like that. Okay, so he dropped in between. But one more thing I want to tell. Tell me.
Yeah, you might be remembering that I have not given the semester exam there in MTech.
Yeah, I know. Actually, because the thing is very clear in his mind because he wants to do only a GATE exam and with a very good rank also. So he dropped in between the MTech because he felt he cannot do two things together, right?
It's not like that, but if I have written the exams of MTech first semester and if I'm passing somehow with the MTech semester, then I would have a backup. So I would not prepare for the GATE well. So I don't want any backup. That's why I have not written the exam also, so that something will be driving me. So you have only one option, that is GATE.
So you gave a third attempt of GATE exam while preparing, while doing MTech, right?
Yes.
So how much rank you got that time?
Yeah, before that, I want to tell that after doing such a risk of leaving the MTech and not writing the semester exams.
Yeah.
This time I got still higher rank, that is nearly 5000 rank.
So you got that much higher rank. So what thought you came in your mind, like how that much rank came, and you knew the failure that time, why this high rank came?
Yeah, it was actually like for the first time I have got little scared. That means even my family don't know that they were thinking that I'm doing MTech, but I have left it. The situation is that I even don't have the MTech nor even the GATE rank. So how I have to face the family or how I have to go home, that was running in my mind. The reason I want to tell why I have got 5000 is it is very important for every aspirant.
Mm-hmm. Why?
Is that I have studied the exam before night. Till night, I think only 4 hours I have slept.
Mm-hmm.
This is a very bad habit for any competitive exam. No one should ever commit this mistake. Mm-hmm. And after going to the exam hall, I was like blanked, and even the simplest questions I could not solve it.
Okay.
So somehow I managed to. So that is the worst thing. After preparing for 3 years, I have faced this situation.
Okay. So it was very, very tough time for you.
Yeah, it is a big mistake, blunder I have done. That means studying after, we cannot prepare for 3 years. How can I prepare in a single day? But didn't strike at the time. So my appeal to all the aspirants is that don't ever do such idealistic things. Be free for last exam before.
Means you are saying that you are preparing up to the last moment, right? So you didn't able to sleep. So you was like you are not in a position to tackle the questions in a very good manner. So that was the main mistake by you.
Yes, mind is blank. That means without sleep, you can imagine how mind works and it's not working in a proper way.
So it is meant. What was the timing of your exam? Morning or evening?
Morning.
Okay.
Usually at 9 o'clock, I think 9 or 8:30, somewhere like that.
Okay. So that time you like if I ask that the preparation was how much strong, like if I think that you slept very good before the exam,
I would definitely get below 200 rank if at all I have written in a better way.
Okay.
With that preparation, I would expect below 200 at that time.
So I just want to explain to our viewers that if you are you are prepared very well for your exam and you are not in a condition to write exam that day, the only day he didn't sleep. So that's why his exam was not up to the mark. So don't do that kind of mistake in your exams. Just prepare yourself before 1 day, 2 day. Just finish your study and take good sleeps and good food also. And everything should be very fine in your exam time, right? So these are the things. Don't do that kind of blunder, right? Anyway, so now you left the M.Tech and your rank was also not that was good. So now, what was your situation? Like, how was your thinking?
Yeah, the initial thinking is that how I should tell my father about this. I have left the M.Tech and I am coming home.
So it was only it's only your decision. It was only your decision that you have left M.Tech.
Yes. As my father was SSC has studied 10th class, so I could not ask the my father about these things. No, so I only have to take decisions.
Okay. So how you face them? Then how you overcome the situation?
Yes, I told something like that. I have told that if anyway I'm doing M.Tech also, I used to get job at only next year, no? So if I travel, I write gate next year, I will get, so it will be balanced like that. I told something.
Okay. So, but how you thinking yourself, by yourself, in 3 years, you didn't able to get that much good rank, and how you will get in the good rank in the next year? How you were thinking that time? For yourself,
I know that I have prepared very well, but only the exam time I have not presented in the last attempt, that is my third attempt. So if at all I could give a last attempt, or you can say that in one more attempt. So if at all I'm doing in a, if at all I'm presenting the content in the exam very good, then I will be definitely a good ranker. That is my motive. So I want to give it again.
So still you are very confident about your preparation, right?
Yeah.
Okay. So what you decided that time that you have to left M.Tech and then again you went home, I think.
Yes.
Then you prepared
Initially, at home I have prepared. As there is no internet, I used to download the videos to going somewhere where there was internet. I used to download and bring home and I used to see all these things. Somehow I managed at the end, that means 3 months before the exam, I have gone to my relative who is staying in NTPC Simhadri. He got job, so I prepared 3 months there, writing the test series and everything.
Okay, so in the last 3 months you prepare from, you went somewhere and you prepare from test series and practicing more and more. So before giving last attempt, how you were thinking, is there any nervousness came in your mind, if something will gone wrong, what will happen, anything you
I was most confident at that time because my test series marks were saying that you were very good this time.
Okay.
So I used to get around 60 to 70 marks, and which is very good for ECE.
Right. Okay. So, what you will say that? How
here
was
I
that?
Want to tell one.
More,
here
please?
I want to tell one point. At the roommates, I used to say that this time my photo will come in the paper like that.
Okay.
That much confident I am.
Okay. But how you control your confidence to overconfidence? Like sometimes things happen. Like if you convert your confidence to overconfidence, you are not preparing that much. Like you are not focusing that much hard work in your preparation. So how you control that thing?
No, overconfidence was not there because I'm not getting more marks. No, I'm getting only 60 to 70. Means I was in a comfortable position that this time you will be in at least in an average state, not the worst state.
Okay. So you first because now your preparation time is so long and you're preparing for so long time. Anyway, but when you sit in the exam, like when you last time, right? So what was the thought before seeing the exam questions? What were you thinking?
Yeah, my thinking is just simple because I have written many test series. So I just that exam also just like a test series. First solving the easy questions and then going for the intermediate level and then the toughest questions. So I somehow written that.
So nothing like that you're preparing for so long. What if things will be wrong? Nothing you are thinking of that like that.
No, luckily those things didn't came into my mind at that time.
That's why I'm asking, in your exam time, like just before the exam time, you must be very positive and your mind must be very fresh so that the outcomes will be very good. Because if he think like what will happen next, or if he didn't get good rank, what is the next? So might be some question may be wrong because of this thinking. Okay, so after the gate you got 146 rank. So whom you tell the first key, I got this much rank?
Yeah, I immediately told to my father that I have got this rank.
Okay.
But initially, so, I have given him hint that I may get around below 500 rank. I told my father that after writing the exam, I may get this rank.
So, from that rank to get in PSU is, I think, very tough. If you got 500 rank, then it's very difficult from AC candidate to go in PSU. I think, right?
Yes. PSU's the situation is tough for AC nowadays because the vacancies were very less.
Okay. Someone is preparing for a long trip, a long period of time. So he may think that what will happen in the future. So what do you want to say to those people who is preparing from long time? Anything you want to say?
The only thing which people should observe is that today they are much more better than yesterday. I can give.
Okay.
Definitely, so, you are learning something, and what will these things or this may hard work will go? There should be some outcome, no? Definitely, it will definitely come when the time comes.
And the thing is that you must have to recognize your reason of failures, right? Why you are lacking? Why are things happening wrong with you? So this thing you have to recognize, and working on that will give you success definitely, right?
Yes. That is the thing. Even when you are taking long time, it doesn't matter. But you should not commit the mistake again and again. The same thing. Right. You have to update yourself. Someday you will get to reach your target.
So we can say that if you are a hard worker and very persistent, like you are preparing continuously, then nothing will stop you. Like you must get success in the end. It may take some more time, but it will be you will be successful in the end, right? And he's the example here. And I also saw his ups and downs. Like he left M-Tech. First he was at home, then he came somewhere, then he again came to relatives to preparing for the exam, for a single exam. And he gave 4 attempts, right? Yeah. And in between the attempt, he got higher rank. So that is the way. But even though he didn't lose hope, he working hard and hard day by day, so that's why he got that much rank. Okay, anyway, so now you were happy, you got 146 rank. So what was the next you have to do? What was your thinking that time?
Yeah, just now then there are again two options, either to go for MTech. But I was too old for that. I think I have wasted three years. Or you have to join the PSU, but the irony is that there were no vacancies, and due to COVID, COVID also entered at that time. There were no vacancies and no notification for electronics for almost, I think, 6 months from then. So okay. I don't have an option. So I have joined MTech in IIT Kharagpur in VLSI.
Okay. There was no notification about any PSU job.
Yeah.
So how
definitely
you
got? There was no. So I was thinking that what happened, and COVID also came now only that is to my fate like that. I am thinking
okay
after getting the rank, so I have to do again MTech. That was my initial thinking.
So then when you came to know that NTPC released the notification after the result?
After 6 months of the result, somewhere when I was in mid MTech for first semester somewhere.
Okay, so you are focused on MTech, right?
Yes.
Okay, so NTPC, please tell me.
Yeah, NTPC has released the notification, but the vacancies were very less. That is 25 posts for both instrumentation engineering and electronics engineering. And if you split that, only EC people will get only 12 posts.
So it's very less. It was very less.
So I never expected that I will be one of those things.
Okay.
So I even not prepared for the interview also. I have just given like that only.
Okay. So for when was your interview? In the after releasing the notification?
I think in the month of June, something in 2020.
Okay. So now we will talk about NTPC interview. Those who are watching this video and who are preparing for NTPC interview and who's from your background, it will be very beneficial for them. Okay. Now, first I want to ask, what is the criteria for NTPC interview? Like from up to which rank they called the aspirant?
Okay. Initially in NTPC, there were three stages. That is, first you have to qualify the gate.
Okay.
And they will give you some cutoff, and beyond that score they will be calling for you for group discussion first and then interview. So you have to qualify in all the three things. Individual cutoffs will be there for group discussion and this for interview also. So after these three stages, if you clear this, then you will be selected.
Okay, but at your time, like when your interview was there, so what was the cutoff of gate score, rank in what do you want to say?
Okay. In my case, for general, I think they have called around some 60 rank open category.
Okay.
For OBC, they have called up to 190.
Okay. So like now is very tough chance to get in NTPC because there are vacancies are very less. So what was your feeling like when you finished the interview? What was your feeling that it is that the feeling or mix, or you are getting good feelings after the interview?
I was thinking that even I have given 100%, even I'm getting 100% marks also, I will not clear NTPC because the posts were only 12 and a lot of people will be there. And it was only for 15% of marks, that is group discussion and the interview.
85%
given for the gate exam. So my rank was 146 and there were many people between. So I even didn't thought of it much that I will be clearing this NTPC.
So how you make it? How you made it?
Yeah, initially I have not made NTPC, but there was one blessing in disguise kind of thing. They have additionally created some 23 posts extra. They have offered
after the interview kind of process. After the interview.
The interviews, they have added some posts of extra 23 posts. In that, I got one.
So that time your luck did very well, huh?
Yes, so it's like blessing in disguise.
Right. We can say that key luck is there. Always we can say that. So luck also plays some important role in your preparation time and your interview time, everything, every time. So anyway, so I will talk about now interview particularly, like how many members are there in your interview panel and how long your interview went, like these things.
Yeah, it is like 3 to 4 people were there.
Oh, yeah. Hmm.
3 to 4 people were there, and it's almost like 25 minutes to 30 minutes mass entry.
Okay, so the JD was first step, personal interview was the first step.
JD was the first.
So in JD, how many members are there, and how you proceed, and what was the topic, and how you can say that? Any tips you want to share about JD?
Yes. Initially, it was a moderator. And eight people, I think, in a group, in a group to participate. So they will be giving you two topics, and you have to select one of those things.
Okay. So what was the topic? Like two topics? You remember? now.
Yeah. One topic I remembered that they have asked me whether the OTT experience can match the theater experience.
Okay. So you decided that topic.
So we have taken that topic, our group, and we have discussed on that.
So is there anything important in JD, like who have to start and how much you have to speak and anything important about JD?
No. Initially, they asked to introduce each and everyone.
Right.
Mm. Okay. As the JD was gone online because of COVID pandemic.
Okay.
So if someone wants to talk, they were asking to raise the hand and they were giving opportunities one by one like that.
Okay. You means your JD was online?
Ah, yes.
It's a great thing. Anyway, so how you perform, like how did you perform like in that JD? How much time you speak and how like how can you say that you put some good point in JD?
Definitely I have made my mark in the JD because I only started the discussion and I only ended the discussion.
Okay, good. So
initially and in between also I think I have raised one or two critical points.
Okay, so it really matters who starts the JD. Yeah, your point matters more much.
It doesn't matter that who starts first, but the way how you are taking forward it, the topic, that's most important.
Right. And you can say we only have to speak only positive point, or we can say some negative point of that topic.
Anything you can say, but you should be in a positive manner. That is some constructive criticism.
Okay. And other thing, I just want to ask about. Personal interview, like for you are saying that your personal interview went for 25 minutes, right?
Yes.
Questions from your technical subjects or some non-technical things were also there.
Okay. Initially, they asked me to introduce yourself and tell about the project, VTech project, like that. Okay. And they also asked me what you are doing for these 3 years. That also they asked.
Okay. So what you replied?
I told that I'm preparing for the exam mostly and I'm doing some.
It did not give any negative impact, like if you're saying that you are preparing from so long. So it is not a negative impactful thing?
No, I don't think that it's a negative thing because I have explained them about my background also.
Okay, right. So first they asked for introduction and then they asked starting technical question or non-tech questions. What was the main?
Initially I have told about my BTech project. One of the interviewer asked me about that project and he slowly come into communication, which is core subject to my.
Okay. So what we can say that the whole interview of technical field, yes, something are there, non-technical.
No, it's a total technical interview.
So what you will say that the questions are very conceptual, very depth questions, are basic questions were there.
Conceptual, definitely they were conceptual, but if you are preparing gate well, that you can answer those things.
Okay, so if your concepts are good, then you can easily crack the interview. And one thing I want to
they were mostly focusing on the observation when you are studying something, whether you have observed this point or not at the time when you are studying. So they were testing all these things.
Only means your practical, how you connect the practical, like the things to theory to practicals. Yes. Okay. So it may happen in your interview, in case of your interview, that some question you are not able to answer, right? So such kind of situation came in your interview also?
Yes, most of the time then that kind of situation has came and I said no, I don't know, something like that.
So it is better to say no or it is better to explain something about that questions?
No, it is not always not preferable to extend the things which we don't know. No, it is better if they can sense if you know or you don't know. So it is better to be frank. If you say don't know, they will ask you next question.
Means it should be like it will be very good if you are so genuine in the interview. Like if you know you can answer directly. If you don't know, then you can say yes, I don't know. Anyway, so how much question you say I don't know, sir? Like how much question? Ratio you can say that percentage anything.
Okay, 30%. I answered 70% and 30% I said.
Okay, so anyway, and you remember some questions from
Yes. They have asked me the communication random variables. They mostly asked me.
Okay. You can ask. You can tell some questions so that the student who is from your background, he can watch the video. He or she can watch this video and may get some benefit.
Okay. He asked me like, what is a video? Video is a stationary thing or non-stationary thing?
Right.
He asked me about what is the variance or how you can derive the variance formula.
Okay.
And he has given me one characteristic equation.
Okay.
And asked me to analyze it, something like that.
So we can say that these questions are very conceptual, and you can tell about some topics like from your background that these topics are so important as the interview point of view. You can if you want to tell.
Yeah, they were mostly asking the things which we have studied in GATE, but they were asking in a different way. That is the thing, not in the objective way, but they were asking in a conceptual way.
Okay.
I think they have asked me about relating my project. My project was based on the image processing, but as we don't know image processing, he told me that I will be asking you on the communication backgrounds. So he asked me on the communication.
Okay, so these things vary from person to person, and things are the things move according to you only. Like if you want, they are asking about some subject you want, you prepared well for the interview. Anything?
No. He just directly picked a point from my project.
Okay.
I have told project. My project is on video based attendance monitoring system. So he asked me about what is a video and how will you process the faces, something like that.
Okay. So in between the interview, you face any kind of nervousness and anything like that? Less confidence.
Definitely, there will be like when you are. You have studied something, but when suddenly sir asked and you are not remembering, that is, I have paused for 1 or 2 minutes. I am asking sir, so that sir, can I try for 1 minute like that? And I have taken time.
Okay, so that's
he
how
has
you
given me time also.
That's how you overcome the nervousness, right?
Yes.
What you want to say for the students who are preparing for NTPC interview or for any interview? How he have to behave in between the interview and how can he maximize his score in between the interview?
First thing, we have to observe what they were expecting from me or what is the expectation of the company from us. So if you take NTPC as an example, they want some reliable people, those who don't leave the company in a much time.
Okay.
So you have to see that aspect, and you should be mostly genuine with your answers.
Okay. Sometimes what happened, like a person who's giving interview, he feels some nervousness. So because of that nervousness, that answer, he is forgetting the concept. Like he start giving wrong answers. So what you want to say for those? How he handle that nervousness so that he give right answers?
Okay. This initially happened with me also. When I was just appeared in the interview panel, that person said that you are so nervous. Why you are like that? Even no one in this world know everything. If you don't know, it is absolutely fine. We also don't know many things like that. He told to normalize me.
Okay. So means panel itself tried to comfort, make you comfortable. Like.
Comfort. Yes. That's what they did.
Okay. So if someone is getting more nervous, you can take some break. You can say, sir, I need 1 minute to stay calm.
No. That you cannot take, but there is no need for nervousness because you only tell what you know. If you don't know, you are saying I don't know. No, so why to make the life complicated by making nervousness?
Okay, so when you this is all about the interview of Mrs. Srinu. Actually, I'm asking now, when you came to know that you got selected in NTPC after the interview, how much time?
It's almost 6 months in the month of March, I think. March 2021, I got the GATE exam in February 2020, and my NTPC result was announced in the March 2021. 1 year it has taken.
You were hoping that you will get finally will any
no, definitely. Even I don't know that there were additional offers also.
Okay.
After getting selected, I have checked that what has happened, and I understood that.
Okay, so we can say that after that much long journey and that much of ups and downs and struggle and difficulties, now things are got settled now, right?
Yes, somewhat.
Okay, now in the end of our video meeting, like, I want to ask you any motivation, any strategy, any tips you want to share with our viewers, please.
Yeah, definitely. First, I will tell you some one or two tips about preparing for the GATE exam.
Right, please.
So whatever we are studying in from the, if you take 1 year of your preparation, at the end, before the exam, that 5 or 6 days, you have to revise everything.
Okay.
So
revision is most important. Revise,
no, I want to tell you.
Okay.
How we can revise those things in that short thing means you have to, as my work, what I have done is that I have written some problems means for a subject 20 to 30 problems which are very different. So if you do those problems, you can complete the entire subject revision.
So
I have planned like that. So you can do at least in a half a day you can complete one subject. So in 3 days you can complete the total revision of all the subjects.
Right. So it's
what I feel is that it is better you write some precise notes or some good problems for each topic for the revision.
Right. Okay.
And also it is better if you maintain a short notes of some formulas also.
Okay.
Formulas for the last end revision.
Okay. Anything you want to say, like your struggle time is so much long. For those who are like preparing from so long time and they are not getting good marks and they are getting negative thoughts. So what do you want to say to stay calm for those?
Yes, definitely. When I am saying that I was too positive, but there were hard times for me also, why I am wasting this much time on this or what I am getting after the GATE, because the vacancies were very less. Even I am getting final rank also, there is no chance of getting the vacancies. But I constantly motivated myself that yesterday I don't know some things, but today I know them. That is my motto. And tomorrow I will know much more. So definitely it will help in some way.
Okay. Means you are focusing on...
The thing is that we are learning. We are constantly learning something.
So you are focusing on learning point of view. Okay. So yeah, it's a very good point. Like, I appreciate this point. Like, if you are focusing on your learning, like, you are not focusing on your future rather, and it will be much better. Your learning growth is very good. That's the point, right?
There is definitely to worry about the life also, because we need to earn, and even the people who are younger than me are also earning at the time, and there was also like some family pressures were also on me that you were wasting your time, and even your parents were selling the land for your studies like that.
Yes. Please, I just want to add one more point here. Like, I forgot to tell, like, you said you told me to you sell some land, piece of land.
Yes, in between we were in some debts, and we lost 1 acre of land. My father sold it to clear the debt, and mostly for my studies also we have spent some money on that. People were saying that what you are achieving by doing all these things, and you are putting the family in trouble, some kind of things were going on. I just ignored them. I never thought of them.
I also say that that's a good way to ignore them. Just take think positive things only, and just continue your hard work so that you will succeed at the end. And these are the things. Anything you want to share other than this?
Yes. Definitely. One last point is that when you work hard and you are giving some time to something, it will definitely repay you. Success can be delayed but cannot be denied.
That's a great point. Success will be there. Success delayed, definitely will be there. I am saying that success will be definitely there for those who are hardworking. It can be delayed, as he said, like, it can be delayed for 1 year, 2 year, 3 year. Like, his struggling time is very long. As I saw, first attempt, second attempt, third attempt, then fourth attempt. After fourth attempt, for PSU there was no vacancy. So that was a difficult time only. And now things are very settled for him. So that's the example. You can be very calm, and you start your work day by day, increase your work, increase your growth, increase your learning. So that's how you have to move, and at the end you definitely will be success. That's the thing, right? Anyway, so in the end I just want to thank you that you gave your time and gave some good points to our viewers. So thank you so much, Srinu.
Okay, thank you, Pankaj, for having me.
Okay, thank you.